What is up, everybody? Jester here, and today we're going to continue down with part two of everything you need to know about your freighter in 2023 in No Man's Sky. Everything from how to get your upgrades, everything you're going to need to unlock cargo, how to get all the different upgrades unlocked. There's so much to cover today, I can't even cover it all in this little part. Let's jump right in. In the last video, I showed you that I absolutely fell in love with this system freighter and that it's going to be just as good as a capital ship. And I've since named it the Chimera. And if you guys want to take a guess as to where that comes from, where I get it from, leave me a comment. But this thing is nothing without upgrades and a fleet surrounding it. So let's get going. To get this very long and, dare I say, very grindy process started, you just need to go to a space station. Now, this can be an outlaw station. It can be tier one, tier two, tier three. For our purposes, it doesn't matter today. Although on an outlaw station, the vendor will be in a different spot. Just go to the same side of the platform where all the other vendors that sell all the upgrades for, say, your exosuit or your ships and stuff is going to be. And we're actually looking for the scrap dealer. He's going to have an item called an emergency signal scanner. We're going to need one of these to locate derelict freighters, which are going to have tons of useful items for us to get this started. Now, just know that the first one of these of the day is 5 million units. You can then continue to buy more so you can do more derelict freighters. It's going to go up exponentially. 10 million units for the second one, 20 million units for the third one, 30 million for the fourth, and then it caps out. So everything beyond that is 30 million units. And as you guys know, I'm not real big on glitches or tricks, but I am going to show you a method today that you only ever need one of these. And I went ahead and did it because I was doing it so many times, and you can make up your own mind as to whether or not that's a road you want to go down. But like I said, this is a grindy enough process without having to worry about units in the background. So do with this information as you're going to. I'll show you that coming up. To use your scanner, all you need to do is go into your inventory and tune the signal once out in space. From there, just pulse jump, and it's going to do its own thing. Eventually, after just a few seconds, it should give you the anomaly detected, and you should be able to drop right out, and right in front of you should be a derelict freighter. And this is going to be where that little trick comes in. Once this is spawned in, what you can do is you can go down and take that signal scanner, and you can put it up into your personal refiner. This is going to save it, because once you open the door, that will consume that item, but it won't do it if it's in your refiner. So just remember, and I'll show you how to get it back out of there and use it again here in a minute. But that is the trick I was going to show you. Use it if you want to. Once out of your ship and you get the door opened up at the terminal, you're going to walk into the first room. And these things are all very different. Mostly what you're going to be looking for here are going to be the blue containers of any kind. There is also the little log snippets that you can pick up. This is going to tell you the story of each of the different freighters. Feel free to pick them up. There's also a couple other things you can do to make a little bit of money here and there when it comes to these, like the crew manifest, and that's coming up here in a second as well. But just know that mostly you're looking for these blue containers, and they're not all just on the ground. They can be lockers, they can be briefcases, and you're going to get a wide variety of different stuff from these, most of which are going to be money. They're going to be nanites. There's going to be certain items like unstable plasma. There's relics. Also know that these briefcases are typically going to be either units, nanites, or something that makes you nanites, like tainted metal here. So this is a good way to get that. Also, just know that there might be enemies when you get into these things, and sometimes they'll attack and sometimes they're pretty docile. Also, a big thing here too is these things are very cold, so kind of take your time with this. Stand by those heating units and let yourself recharge a bit, because your protection is going to go down extremely quick. Every once in a while, you're going to run into one of these type of items, which is going to be a little terminal where you can find a crew manifest, and you can sell these to make some of your money back for the day. You also might find upgrades that you can use to upgrade different things, like your thermal protection there, or your suit, or any other different thing. Sometimes you're going to run into other items that are going to be useful, including base parts. Here you see we got an industrial bench. So there's plenty of things to be searching for on all of these, including all the different things you can refine down to nanites. But the main feature that we're going to be here for is at the engineering control, and that is going to be our upgrades. And this is going to be what you use to upgrade your ship. Now, just know that not every freighter drops S class, but when you find one that drops S class, it will always be an S class. To get it, just fabricate the technology module. It'll then do it. It'll show you whatever level you're going to get. The cargo bulkhead you can also create. I'll show you that in a moment. But that is going to be standard across the board. If you're only getting A-class, it'll only ever be A-class on this freighter. So you're going to want to go to a new system and try a different freighter so you can get to S-class. Once you complete everything at the engineering control, activate the teleporter and head back towards your ship. This will put you back at that first room or near the first room. From here, you can go ahead and get into your personal refiner and put that that scanner back into your inventory. And then from there, it's really pretty simple. You just kind of get away from this derelict freighter and you pulse. If you have multiples of these, you don't have to worry about this at all. But as you are pulsing, you go back into your inventory and you retune the signal and you can just reuse this thing over and over. The second major thing that you're going to want to grab at these engineering terminals are the freighter bulkheads. In my opinion, these are just as important as getting the upgrades, because this is going to be what you use to unlock your technology slots as well as your cargo, which you're going to need going forward. So just know you're going to be committed to running a lot of derelict freighters. Just know that getting max upgraded, you're going to need three each of the following: the fleet fuel unit, fleet combat unit, fleet trade unit, fleet mining unit, the fleet beacon, which is speed, fleet exploration unit, and the salvage hyperdrive, which makes your freighter actually jump much further. Again, these are RNG, so it could take a while to get three of each. The last main thing you're going to be looking for on these derelict freighters, and I know a couple of different ways to get them, are the salvage frigate modules. And those are going to be used for something also just very, very important. And just, you don't have to just get these here. You can also search the crashed freighters that are going to be on the ground. And if you go around to the different cargo pods, this is also going to be inside the loot table. Now, I can't tell you what the actual percentage is because you can find all kinds of things here. But just know that you might get it on the first try. You might not get one per. But this is another option when it comes to getting these. You're also going to be getting some other stuff that you have to remove that can make you some nanites. So there's kind of a perk in that as well. Now that we know all the different things that we're going to need to get this freighter upgraded, it's time to start putting these things into practical use. And I'm going to do this in a particular order, and I actually went to an expedition save so I can show you the cost of some of these things. Let's jump into it. Salvage frigate modules are used to unlock not only the tree of research that you can do, and I would highly recommend getting the right side of this done before the left because those are temporary modules, but you're also going to be able to unlock base building parts for inside of your freighter. So as you can see, you're going to need quite a few of these as well. The other thing you can do here in this section is you can buy colors using nanites, 5,000 apiece, 50,000 total to get them all, and most of your freighter you can change colors with, which is kind of nice. After about 6.5 hours work, I finally had everything I needed to get this thing upgraded. And the funny part is, I'm not even going to keep this freighter. So I'm really just going to use minimal bulkheads on this to get the technology installed. But as you can see, this is kind of the way you want it to look. You want to have three of each of these upgrades and a fairly good amount of the cargo bulkheads. I recommend starting off with technology. It's kind of up to you as to how you want to handle it. You can start with cargo if you want to. But I just like to get technology going. To get this going, it works a whole lot like a ship does. But this one you do with the upgrade control as part of your main control panel here. And just make sure you select the technology slots. Or if you want cargo, make sure you're selecting the cargo, which happens by default. But this way you can expose exactly where your supercharged slots are going to be. And again, on an S-class, you're going to get four. And this is going to kind of matter a little bit. But again, I'm not going to do a whole bunch here. Now, once we finally got everything going, I thought, well, let's do the hyperdrive first, because I think this is what everybody's going to ask about. And for me, it kind of doesn't matter, and we'll talk more about that in a minute. But I wanted to get these installed and make sure that they were all ready to go with all the upgrades. And as you can see, in the end, 5,198 is what I got. So that's really not bad. And I actually ended up making a change on this, which is weird because I didn't want to use three of my four supercharged slots. I wanted to do an experiment to see if we supercharged some of the other upgrades, how much that would mess with fleet coordination. And in the end, I found out that it's kind of just a weird number. I think it's kind of arbitrary because with fully upgraded, this thing's a beast, man. Still over 5,000 light years, 5,085.3. It has 2.7 warp efficiency, which seems to be standard across the board with all the upgrades, and a fleet coordination of 53.8. And again, this is a thing that I'm not even going to keep. So just so you know, it is what it is. But, you know, anytime you can jump over 5,000 light years, that's a pretty big number. Although I don't know a lot of people that jump around in their freighter. But hey, you could if you wanted to. It's totally available for you. And finally, it's time to work on the freighter that I am going to keep. And I'm going to be paying a little more special attention to this one because I don't even know where the hypercharge slots are at this point. And I don't really want to use them all for the hyperdrive, but we'll see what we get. And the funny part about my freighter is I ended up with more questions than answers. I ended up putting all of my hyperdrive, my best ones, in the supercharged slots. This gives me 5,054. So I'm going to have to say that the capital ship's hyperdrive is going to be better than a system freighter. Although I was still able to get this within just like 4 light years. I don't think it's a lot better, maybe 100, 150 light years, not that big. But a funny thing happened here. When I took one of the Expedition or the other upgrades out and put it into a supercharged slot, I was able to raise the fleet coordination even more. And that's with the Venator class having two of those different upgrades in separate supercharged slots. I only had two hyperdrive modules in there. So I'm just going to have to start doing some configuration and figure out what the heck's going on with this. But by and large, these things are identical, just like I said. It's just the way they work. Another thing that I haven't mentioned at this point is that there's something that is kind of new with this, and that's that you can reuse every one of these upgrades you see except for the hyperdrive itself, because every one of these freighters comes with a hyperdrive. To prove this, hover over anything, and you're going to want to store the technology. From there, just move it into your exosuit. It's gone from here, and you can put that back in anytime you want to. And to prove that, here we go, install. And you can just put it right back in. So this should make the idea of changing your freighter a little more attractive, even though you're still going to have to go out and do more derelict freighters to get more cargo bulkheads to open up all your tech and your cargo slots and things like that. But definitely for me, it makes it a lot more attractive to know that I don't have to recraft all these things or go regrind all the different upgrades and be subject to RNG ever again. Unfortunately, this is the part of the video where I have to tell you there's just going to have to be a part 3. Now, I never intended for there to be a part 3. I wanted to, even if it was going to be a long video, which is technically not very good for my channel analytics and my viewership, it's just a little long. I was willing to do that just so we can kind of consolidate this and not try to stretch it out into 3 videos. But as you guys know, anybody who's watched me for a little bit knows that I'm committed to making quality content that's not just cookie cutter stuff. And today I have to tell you, there's just a big problem right now with living frigates and the Dream Aerial, and something just doesn't work as intended. And I can't seem to find a workaround for it. 2 days ago, when I went out and filmed the original encounter with the living frigate, I was able to get it, no sweat. I later in the day went back out and forgot to record the second encounter, but was able to get one. So I dismissed both of those. I went back in just yesterday and was able to go back out. And I can't seem to get this encounter to spawn again, period, no matter what I do. I've been using anomaly detectors in conjunction with the Dream Aerial. Nothing seems to work. I've gone to all the different SAR systems. I've pulsed around for up to 20 minutes a system, and I'm going to find a way. I will find a way to make this work so I can bring you guys and show you how to get this done. It may even be as intensive as having to create a new save, get back to this point in the game line, and just do it all over again. So, but hopefully you guys appreciate that kind of commitment. And if you do, please subscribe to the channel, especially if you're new. And if you're not new, don't forget to like, because it really helps the algorithm a ton. And I'm going to get back to work. I'm going to go get on this because I would love to get this out there and get this information available for you. So until next time, guys, thank you again for watching. And thank you again for all the support. It really does mean the world. We'll see you soon. Bye.